up to the locals, honestly. We'll give them a chance. We encourage them. You know, even I had plans before all we assembled the team to have a psychologist to talk to them before, you know, they join the camp. And so the challenge is up to them. I would like to give the chance to the locals more. When I started playing, the likes of Ripon Manso, Ama Senega, and they were senior guys, you know, Mayanga, you know, and then Salifu Ansan, the goalkeeper. We had majority of locals into the team, in the national team, compared to, you know, even I started as a local, I started playing as a local player before I even traveled abroad. It has changed, you know, I mean, it has changed. And I think it's up to us to try as much as we can to improve that area, because there's a big gap. You know, the locals, when you see them with the professionals, there's a big gap. And that is up to them. Of course, once we see a player doing well, I will give him that chance. And they should also believe that they are coming to play, not even to be on the bench. They should believe that, and that will show automatically in training. You know, these are kind of things they will have to do, and it has to come from the individual. Yes, we've seen them, we've invited them. I'm not going to close my eyes on them once they are there and they are doing well. You know, they like somebody like Blay. You know, he looks active. When he's playing, he looks hungry. I like people who are hungry and want to be successful. It's not just one match, two matches. And my research tells me in Ghana, no player has been able to play 3 matches on the top. 3, 4. It's a challenge. They should challenge me. You know, so I'll follow you here, there, by the 4th match. 1st match on the high, 2nd match in the middle, 3rd match drop, and then he goes. No, they need to be consistent with their performance. And they will automatically get in there.